وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. In this episode, I want inshallah ta'ala to bring to light the relationship between Ramadan and supplication, dua, and how important it is that we use this month to beg and supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. First of all, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He tells us in the Qur'an, He says, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِي إِذَا دَعَانِ فَلِيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. In this ayah, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He tells us, and He says to us, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِي إِذَا دَعَانِ وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِي إِذَا دَعَانِ. Allah says, if my slave asks me, I am close. I accept the dua of the one who supplicates to me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us that there is a role upon the creation. And there is also something that Allah will do in response to that. What is upon you is to supplicate and to invoke unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's the one who's going to respond to that dua. And that's what the ayah told you. You supplicate, and I will accept your dua. وَلِذَٰلِكَ There are people whose dua is never rejected. It's accepted. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us. The Prophet said, ثَلَاثٌ Three people. دَعْوَاتٌ مُسْتَجَابَاتٌ Three types of people, their supplication is accepted. The first one is da'watu al-sa'imi, the dua of the one who is fasting. Wa da'watu al-madlubi, and the da'wa, the dua of the one who is being oppressed. Wa da'watu al-musafiri, and the dua of the traveler. The dua of the one who is fasting is accepted based on this hadith. And the ayah before said, if you make the dua, Allah will accept it from you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what are you waiting for, my beloved brothers and sisters? We just have to call unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to beg Him. We need to show Him that we are in need of Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us, أَفْضَلُ الْعِبَادَةِ الدُّعَى The best form of ibadah is to supplicate. In another wording, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, الدُّعَى هُوَ الْعِبَادَةِ That dua is ibadah. So if ibadah is a very comprehensive term, the best of it is what? Is a dua. Supplicate. The best month is Ramadan. The best ibadah is to supplicate. Then we need to make sure that Ramadan doesn't come except that we beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Especially the fact that we know that there are people whose necks are going to be freed from the hellfire. The Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ تَعَالَى عُتَقَاءَ فِي كُلِّ يَوْمٍ وَلَيْلَةٍ لِكُلِّ عَبْدٍ مِّنْهُمْ دَعْوَةٌ مُسْتَجَابَةٌ That Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, every day and every night, He has a people who He frees their neck from the hellfire. لِكُلِّ عَبْدٍ مِّنْهُمْ Every slave from amongst them, his dua was accepted. دَعْوَةٌ مُسْتَجَابَةٌ His supplication was accepted. Al-Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahimahullahu ta'ala, they came up to him one day, a group of people, and they asked him a question. They said to him, Kam baynana wa bayna arsh al-Rahman? How much is between us and the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Yani what's the duration and the distance between us and the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Al-Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, Al-Imam Ahmad was asked this question, what is the distance between us and the throne of Allah? And then Imam Ahmad rahimahullah responded fast and quick, and he said, "Da'watun sadiqah min qalbin sadiq." It is a truthful supplication from a truthful heart. That is the distance between us and the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yani here what he means that Imam Ahmad is, Jannatul Firdaus, the roof of Jannatul Firdaus is Allah's throne subhanahu wa ta'ala. For you to get there is to supplicate, to beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow you to be from the people of that station. Some people today, they actually think that if they make dua, it should be responded to straight away. And if it doesn't, then what's the point of me making the dua? I've already made dua before and it never got accepted, so I'm not going to do it again. And that is a misunderstanding of how the dua works. And it also is ignorance on the part of the person who is thinking that way. You shouldn't busy yourself with whether dua is accepted or not. You should be focused on making the dua. And Umar radiallahu anhu was a great companion. He said, "Inni la ahmilu hamm al-ijaba." I don't carry on my shoulders. I don't burden myself with whether the dua is accepted or not. Walakin hamm al-dua. But rather what I burden myself with is, have I made the dua? فَإِذَا أُلْهِمْتُ الدُّعَى. Because I know if I'm guided to making the dua, he said, فَإِنَّ الْإِجَابَةَ مَعَى. Because the acceptance is with the dua. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِي إِذَا دَعَانِ. You should busy yourself with making the dua. The answer to your dua was with the supplication. The dua doesn't have to be, the dua that you asked, the response and the answer for it comes in different ways and shapes and forms. It is not always the way you want it to look like. So ponder over that. My beloved brothers and sisters, many of us are suffering around the world. We're going through hardship. We're seeing loved ones that we've had who passed away. Virus has come around. It's taken loved ones from us. It's this opportunity, it's this time that we turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with repentance and we beg Him to remove this distress, this hardship, and that He brings about harmony, safety, prosperity, success, and tranquility back to our hearts and minds. There is no one else who can uplift this from us except Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. If the coronavirus outbreak has shown us something, it has shown us how weak we are as creation. And how incompetent we are. That Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has the ultimate power and strength. He brought a virus that our eyes cannot see. Even the microscope that is used to look at it is a particular type for them to see it with. Not every microscope can see the coronavirus. Ponder over that. It's a silent killer. وَمَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودَ رَبِّكَ إِلَّا هُ. No one knows the army of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except Him. And this truly was sent down for us to humble ourselves and to humiliate ourselves to Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَلَقَدْ أَخَذْنَاهُمْ بِالْعَذَابِ فَمَا اسْتَكَانُوا لِرَبِّهِمْ وَمَا يَتَضَرَّعُونَ. Allah says, we put them through distress, punishment and harm and hardship. But they didn't humiliate themselves to Allah. They didn't humble themselves to Allah. They didn't turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what was needed from them. Also, my beloved brothers and sisters, supplication is something Allah loves. And when we don't supplicate, it angers Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know the creation, the more you ask, the more you beg them, the more they hate you. The more they become repulsed to you. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more you ask Him, the more He loves you. And the less you ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you turn away from supplicating to Him, the fact that He doesn't love you subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّهُ مَنْ لَمْ يَسْأَلِ اللَّهِ يَغْضَبْ عَلَيْهِ. Anyone who doesn't ask Allah for anything, it angers Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. And another wording says, مَنْ لَمْ يَدْعُ اللَّهَ يَغْضَبْ عَلَيْهِ. Anyone who doesn't supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah becomes angry with him. So let's not choose the wrath of Allah over the mercy of Allah. And also, let's not miss this opportunity. Ramadan, شهر المغفرة, a month of forgiveness, a month of العتق من النيران, being taken away from being the dwellers of the hellfire and becoming the inhabitants of Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to be from the inhabitants of Jannah and take us far from the hellfire and anything that would lead to it. إِنَّهُ وَلِيُّ ذَلِكَ وَالْقَادِرُ عَلَيْهِ. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.
Assalamu alaikum. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amauathome.com.